Okay, I'm here to do the first of many Gundam reviews. I'm going to start off with the first series and go up. I don't have everything. I'm missing Unicorn, and I'm also missing a little bit of Double Zero, and any of the Japanese stuff, like Turn, X, or anything else I may be missing. There's too much Gundam to get. But I did hear that Turn of Gundam is coming out in English. They're in production right now, so that should be really cool to get. Unfortunately, my favorite, which is Double Zeta, isn't coming out yet. Everybody else didn't like it, but I did. So let's get on with the first review. Alright. So this is the original Gundam series. And sorry for the fan in the background, but it's really hot. Like always. These are the single DVDs. Unfortunately, I don't know if there are any other versions besides the Region Zero version. Basic standard stuff. They look really good, I think. All the covers are really nice. Inside, this is the only one I'm going to do this for because they all have the same stuff, a little advertisement. They all have this little flyer, and then they all have the disc that looks exactly like the front. So, no point in opening up every single one of them. If they were different, I would do it, but side, same thing, it's same as the front, and has the battle begins down at the bottom for the first disc. The first disc has 5 episodes. Amuro Ray, one of my favorite characters. I don't know who my favorite would probably, I don't really know who my favorite character would be. Anyways, moving right along, disc 2. Got Char Aznable on the front and on the back here. This one goes another 5 episodes. The extras are kind of cool. They're kind of like Gundam bios. Next we have, forgot his name, Garma, I think, and his girlfriend with the Gundam on the front. This is actually his death in this one. And we have the gun cannon and Sayla on the back. And I believe, yeah, this one goes to 4 episodes. I think they all started going to 4 episodes. Ramba Rawl's appearance, Amuro has to fight him, and there he is right there. Better shot in his mobile suit, the Duff. On the back, it just has really nice pictures of all the characters in their mobile suits. Except for Sayla. Sayla doesn't always pilot anything. Then we got Bright and the White Vase on the back of this one. Again, 4 episodes. This is a really nice cover. It has almost all the... It has the main characters of the White Vase on here. The ones that matter, anyways. And this is Ryu, and he actually dies in this video. And it's actually one of the first... I think this is one of the first animes to have a main character die in the anime and not come back using Dragon Balls or souls or spirits or any of that stuff. Once they're dead in this show, they're dead for good. They don't come back. Then you got the other one here, which is Disc 6. Oh yeah, they're all nicely numbered too, which is really good. Got Gundam and the, I think they're called the Black Star Squadron or something. Lady, I forgot what her name is. Oh well, but here's one of the Doms of the Black... Oh, the Black Triad, that's what they're called, it says right there. The Black Triad. Number 7, with Char's red, Ziok, whatever the heck that thing's called. Miss Matilda and the gun tank. Again, 4 episodes. We got the Big Zom, which is always a pain in the ass to beat in any of the games. Blue, I forgot what they're called, so I'm just gonna leave it like that. Deadwind Zabi, the leader of the Zeons. Lawless Sue, which becomes a main character, like a big part of the show. We got Amuro right here on the side, and Char over here, and Lala in the middle. Then on the back, we got Gundam again, and then we have, Frabo. Story's basically about, Amuro Ray, which is on the final DVD right here. He's a pilot for the Mobile Suit Gundam, but he becomes a pilot not by choice. He's kind of thrown into a war that he doesn't want to be a part of, but ends up becoming one of the best pilots there is, and he becomes what they call new types. And I believe they're changed later on, but in the first series of Gundam movies and shows, they're just called new types. And we got Lala here in her mobile armor. I forgot what it's called. I haven't watched them all yet. Well, I mean, I've watched them all way before, but I mean, recently. I got these back when I was in middle school and early high school. Yeah, so they're pretty old. It's an anime from the 80s. But not the DVDs, obviously. So, yeah, he's thrown into a war. He's labeled as a new type. There's Char, who's his arch enemy, who's also a new type. And later on, they join forces together. And that's going to be in the next couple of sagas. So here they all are nicely together. And this show is also shown on Cartoon Network. That's not where I got my version of seeing it. Like, I didn't watch it on Cartoon Network first. I did for the other Gundam series, but this one I actually knew about from a friend of mine. He showed me it in Japanese, and I just wanted to get them all after that. First episode I saw was Char and Amuro, and I forgot who else, but they were all fighting in this canyon area, like Battle in Texas, I think it's called. I think it's actually on one of these later episodes. Let's see, is it in any of these? I'm not seeing it. Nope, I don't think it's in any of these. Can't be in the past ones like that. Yeah, well, it's in one of these somewhere. Showdown in Texas, I think it's called. But anyways, for all of those who did see it on Cartoon Network, this opening will probably look familiar to you. So here's a little nostalgia.
Now is the time for mankind to stand up for the future.
Of the Medea squadron set out to rescue the heavily damaged White Base, but found themselves attacked by Goofs and Dodai attack bombers. Amuro and the others quickly rallied together to assist the Medea. With the help of the G-modules designed to upgrade Gundam, they succeeded in defeating the enemy.
Yeah, so that's a little bit of Gundam for you. I was probably way too close. Sorry you had seen up close to my face. And my messed up hair just got out of the shower. So that is the first of many to come Gundam series reviews. Quick ones. Don't really know what else to say after that. So, see ya.